I went to Kramer's there and got 2 pounds of sausage.
I hear it's wonderful meat. I've never had anything.
Well, he always makes this apple sausage, you know.
Ooh.
Yeah. I bought this.
Yeah, but I don't know.
The officials and the team captains are at the center of the field for the coin toss.
Yeah, they were certainly, we touched on that a little bit last year. They were certainly some outstanding Notre Dame teams back then, and there have been in recent years, but back then there was quite a team that Notre Dame had on the field for those few years. You talked about the backfield of Calvini, you mentioned running back. Matt Tappatelli is the quarterback. He's just a sophomore. That's one of the things that Coach Marcelli thinks is going to really balance out this offense, is that Tappatelli is going to be really coming up and
oh, my God.
bank. Conversion is incomplete from Capitelli to Keeley.
Thank you.
pass by Mike Reddick.
Thank you. Thank you. McVay can hold that run out.
Turn as Lucas Weaver on the stop. Falls at the 43-yard line. Incomplete. The end goal. Sabato on the coverage. Thank you. Third and three for Raiders. top by Stefano and Reddick.
Oh!
Flynn and Dan Tresco. Thank you.
sure.
Yeah.
fast. Too many putts short when you're playing match play and you got to run at it.
So all square through two, Faldo and Strange, and ahead to seven. Jeff Maggard, birdie to win the hole.
See the speed of this putt. Two great putts in a row by Maggard.
Birdies at six and seven, and Jeff Maggard cuts the lead to two down.
And this is Ian Woosnam to win the hole for birdie at the par 3-6th. And Fred Couples still has a par putt to try and have the hole. Send you back to one.
And the first tee, Dan Hicks, Corey Pavin, and Bernard Longer. And the great Byron Nelson into the Hill of Fame here at Oak Hill, inducted this year. An incredible 50 years ago, can it be, when he ran off that string of incredible wins.
One of the real legends of the game and one of the nicest men ever to play the game. And Bernard Longer's been getting a little bit of flack this week because he has been slower than slow.
Corey Pavin and Bernard Longer are two players with a flair for the dramatic. Their history goes back 8 years to the final round of the 87 Bob Hope Classic, tied with Longer at 76th hole. A birdie putt at 18 to win the tournament. Yesterday in the Ryder Cup, they were at it again. Longer and his morning foursomes match, a pivotal chip in for birdie at the 12th hole. And you know what's coming next. Pavin capping the day, a match-winning chip at 18. Once again, the victim, Longer. Appropriately paired in the singles today, as you look at Longer's 2-2 and 3 record.
It's just a total coincidence because, in case you don't know how this works, each captain just submits their list, and who knows why the order, and it's just coincidental that they run up against each other.
So you just put 12 names down, 1 through 12, the other puts one down, and it just matches the two sides.
This is singles match number 10. Representing Europe, Bernhard Langer. Representing the United States, Corey Pavin.
Johnny Miller, one thing that's not a coincidence.
The referee for this match is Mark Kazire.
The commonality of their fiery spirit.
Bernhard Longer.
There's no doubt about that. Both of them are mentally probably as smart as any players in the world, these two guys. And Bernhard, there is nothing that gets by him. And I'll tell you, he will not hit a ball till he's done, gone through all the hoops and gotten ready to hit it. Probably the most consistent golfer in the last 20 years, the most consistent golfer, and might, who knows, might even be, have the best record of anybody the last 20 years.
Duck in the fact, Couples have six. He made that putt, so he remains two down to Woosnam.
It's going to barely go into the
Playing
primary
the
rough.
States,
That's
Mr.
not a
Corey
good break.
Pavin.
That's a tough break right there for Bernhard.
3-1 in this 95 Ryder Cup is Corey Pavin. That's more than the combined effort of the two stars for Europe, Faldo and Montgomery, who are 2-6.
This is his third Ryder Cup, Corey's, and then Bernhard is, this is his eighth.
Thank you.
that. He hit it just down the left side with a little fade. That ball was low. I mean, we're talking real low. That was a, sort of a skanker.
The ball disappearing in that heavy left rough. Let's go to four.
David Guilford with a birdie to win the hole and take the lead.
Wow.
They call him the silent assassin in England.
Five. Costantino Rocca for par. Davis Love has a par putt left. Roger?
Well, it's about 5 feet up the hill. Inside the cup on the right, hit it firm.
Good solid stroke there.
Roger, he's hardly missed a putt inside 10 feet all week that we've been watching. He's just solid as can be.
He's just played beautiful in all facets of the game, Johnny. I mean, he's hitting the ball solidly every time. And he really, putting, which would have been considered the weakest part of his game, has been very, very good.
Maybe that putt he missed at Keogh was just a fluke. You know, maybe this guy is dead solid, and we've been thinking the other things about him. I mean, the belfry, I'm sorry.
Well, John, he is a very good player. I think the more you be able to watch him, as Davis has to make this to tie the hole, you'll become a real fan of Costantinos because he's a good player.
Davis Love with a par. And this match remains all square through five.
Paraded in the European press after a 93 Ryder Cup loss, failing to hold a lead at the Belfry against Davis Love, Costantino Rocca redeemed himself 2 months ago at the British Open, part of an emotional two-year roller coaster for the 39-year-old Italian.
Few days in golf have been more choked by pressure than the 93 Ryder Cup. In singles, American Davis Love faced Italian rookie Costantino Rocca. Through 16 holes, the underdog Rocca held a one-up lead.
I came off 16 green and I saw all the wives and all the players that had finished their matches and everybody, all the press and everybody was there. I knew it was coming down to my match and we'd hit off the tee and we're walking off and Tom said, you know, we really need this point. It's coming right down to the wire. And I said, well, he's due to miss a putt and I'm due to make one. I said, I haven't made a putt all day and he's been making a bunch and, you know, he's not supposed to make this many putts.
You had to feel confident. You just made a couple of birdies and then you get to 17. And what was going through your mind? It's 17.
I hit the putt for just for make two putts. After the hole, the ball ran very quickly. And after I missed.
I knew then something was starting to eat at him. And then when he missed the putt, I stayed on the greens. I kind of sensed it after he ran that putt by that it was gonna, the tide was gonna turn.
I missed two putts. Yeah. I missed one putt, which is very important, 17. It's a game. It's no, it's a war, no?
Rocca was philosophical about the loss, but the press wasn't as forgiving. After spending 2 years trying to prove he wasn't a golfer who collapsed under pressure, Rocca came to the final hole of this year's British Open, and again he failed as the world watched. He had one last chance.
And Mike Eddy told me, take your time. You can't make it this putt. And I hit the ball. When I see Mike Eddy, he's coming, he's coming, he's coming. And I just look up like this. And when I see the ball go inside the hole, it's unbelievable.
And there is the par 3-6th where Rocca electrified the galleries here with his ace in the morning yesterday. Davis Love will play first.
Davis has an 8-iron, playing 160 yards, slightly downhill, just a comfortable 8-iron for Davis. Just about a club stronger than Costantino Rocca. Left of the flag, cutting back slightly, good looking shot.
Another look at the ace by Rocca Saturday morning.
This hole played a little longer yesterday because the pin was back at 174 yards.
And into the arms of his partner Sam Torrance at this match all square.
5 iron yesterday.
Missed a 7 iron today. Looking shot just right of the flag.
So Costantino Rocca trying to chase the demons of the belfry, taking on Davis Love III, holding his own. They are all square. USA leads at 9-7, leads one match. Europe leads 3 matches, 5 all square.
Every Sunday, there's comedy on NBC on an all-new Brotherly Love. Matt is teacher's pet, but Joe is teacher's... Can't they share?
Where the heck would you take on your first date, huh?
Homeroom? On Minor Adjustments, Coach Ron has a problem.
Are you firing me?
We prefer to think of it as downsizing by one.
All-new family comedy, NBC tonight.
Every golfer knows the rule. Play the ball where it lies.
Nice shot, man.
When you visit South Carolina, you'll see just how enjoyable it can be to play by the rules. Over 200 courses and weather that invites you to play all year round. For your free South Carolina golf guide, call 1-800-872-2102.
We didn't put Dodge Intrepid's windshield in the usual place. We moved it forward and down to enhance visibility and aerodynamics. The wheels were moved toward the corners to make it more stable. And now many features that were options are standard. So even though Intrepid has air, speed control, power windows, and more, the price isn't where you'd expect to find it either. It's lower. Dodge Intrepid. This changes everything.
Gives you more ways to add the impact of color to black and white documents. Xerox Color. A simpler way to do good work.
The Ryder Cup today, tonight at 7, live on 10 NBC.
You are watching the 31st Ryder Cup matches on NBC.
Bottom right, two tandems yet to play, Haas Walton and Mikkelsen Johansson. You see three European flags, those men in the lead. And Lehman has a one-up advantage against Ballesteros at the turn for the only U.S. lead.
Well, right now, Europe's doing what it needs to do to make this sort of surprising comeback and maybe give them a shot at winning back the cup.
Let's go to the sixth, Dan.
Okay, Dick. Davis Love III and Costantino Rocca, and it was interesting, Dave Marr. I think the comments made by Davis Love III, he said he was more nervous this Ryder Cup than in his rookie year because he knew Captain Lanny Watkins was counting on him, leaning on him.
Well, with so many rookies on the team, and he's already been in it once, and the players do look up to the guys and say, what can we expect? You know, why is this so different than an Open or a PGA or a Masters or something? The pressure is entirely different, and I'll tell you.
Roger Maltby, what is this putt going to do?
Well, overall, it's going to move a little bit from his left to right. It is downhill, a little on the quick side. But in the middle of the putt, it looks like it almost wants to eke a tiny bit left, but at the hole, it will move back right. And this is another one of those new greens, and these are really tough to read, Johnny.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that. We have seen very, very few putts made on these new greens.
Feelings about the pressure of performing in the Ryder Cup?
Well, I thought the Sunday pressure of the Ryder Cup would be similar to the Sunday pressure of a Masters or a U.S. Open, but I think it's more intense than that after being in the hunt a couple of times this year in majors. I know that there's a lot of pressure on you to try to win the Masters at the U.S. Open, but it's only you that really, really deep down cares. And when you're doing it for your team, you know, you've got 11 other guys and a captain standing there going, all right, let's see if you can win this point, because it's very, very important. And, you know, I think last time around, being in that situation, coming down the stretch will help me. After that, it's got to get a little bit easier. But for the rookie guys that haven't done it before, they're just not going to imagine, you know, how much pressure there really is when it comes down to crunch time trying to win a point.